All right, welcome back. This is just like a quick little informal video. First off, you know, as I grow this channel, I want to find out what is going to be valuable to you. There's a lot of things you pick up along the way in photography. And I remember at the time those things, you know, working so hard or struggling so much to find out that, oh, I could have done it so much easier had I known X. So I thought maybe I could share some of those things that I've learned along the way. And it's kind of the case of you don't really know what you don't know, right? So maybe within these videos, I'll just try to share a little bit here and there, and that might prompt a question or be the bit of information that you've been looking for or something that you've been struggling with. But yeah, I wanted to ask you all, you know, what can I do? What can I film that's going to be, I mean, not just entertaining, but valuable and useful to you as you go along your path of, you know, being a photographer or whatever it is. And also, as you can see, I'm filming a lot of talking head stuff. And, well, we're 60 miles from the Canadian border and it is January 19th. So we're going to be inside for a little bit. I'm not a ski photographer. And as things do warm up in the spring, I definitely want to take the video camera and follow along on some of my personal shoots, maybe some of my advertising work, and I don't know, just do a lot more outside of the office. But for right now, it's January in Montana. This is not the end-all, be-all of the channel. So there's that. So now to the point of the video. A photo career is not just going to happen for you. You have to happen to it, and duh, right? But I don't know, there's this mindset that I've heard on a couple of different podcasts, and I've heard from, you know, just talking to people over the years. I don't know how to describe it. It's kind of like this mindset of feeling like you deserve these chances, or you're waiting for and also expecting things to happen for you or some break. And I mean, that's just not the case in anything. One of the biggest misconceptions is that we see people all the time blow up for different reasons, right? And it's so easy to forget that generally, if you dig a little bit deeper, there are many years of hard and unrecognized work behind that. And so here's the deal. If you want a photography career, you're going to have to work every day. And so I have a note, I have a list here that has three words written on it. The first word is time. You're going to have to spend a lot of time doing this. It's going to kind of, in a way, have to become your life. You can't really half-ass it. And so for you to be able to spend that amount of time doing this, you'd better be interested in what you're doing. So find something you're specifically interested in and go down the rabbit hole. That is going to be the only thing that keeps you interested and engaged and advancing for the amount of time that it's going to take for you to start to get those big breaks that come your way. And after you've done all that, which is, it's a never-ending process, along the way, I should say, these opportunities are going to arise. And really, sometimes you're not going to understand what they are at the time. Something that I've always just gone by is, what does my gut tell me? Should I go forward with this opportunity or not? That could be an entire other video. I mean, in 2017, we got a call for this big, long job shooting all across America for, what's the evil company that owns all the seeds? And yeah, for that company. And my agent and I were like, no way. And that probably would have been a job where it's like, you don't have to work for a few years after that. But again, you're not in this for a few years or for a payoff. If you're really doing this, you're after a career and a lifetime of doing this. And since that is going to become so singular with you, your values have to really be present in every facet of the way you operate. So there's that. But again, you're working, you're interested, you're spending time, you're engaged, you're bringing, not instantly, but you're bringing something different to the table, which is you, right? That's the only thing you have over any other photographer. So you better damn well do what you want to do and are interested in. It's kind of one of the few times in life where it's good to be selfish. So remember that. But as you've been working for years, opportunities are going to come up. And, you know, you might not realize how important some of them are at the time. But as you look back, you'll start to recognize different things. You know, some jobs will come in with a lot of money, and that will give you a runway to further pursue what you're really interested in. Other jobs will come in, and maybe they don't have that kind of budget, but they give you the creative opportunities to, you know, actually make the work that you feel like you need to. So there's these different balances coming in from other jobs. You know, and years later, or months, it just depends. You're going to get a call or an email or something, and you'll get one of those big opportunities. And it's good to remember how you might feel right now about seeing other people getting these opportunities. At that time, when you get to that place, when it's happening to you, you're going to be more thankful than you ever could have been, because really only then do you know how much it took of yourself for those things to happen, right? That word luck is not a part of it. The people who are lucky have been doing the right things for long enough to be able to be identified for opportunities, to have those, and to do them again and again. And what that all boils down to is you every day doing your work. And you're not always going to know what you need to be doing. It'll be easy to feel guilty for feeling like you're not productive. So something that I wish I would have identified earlier was that, you know, I felt like I had to come in here, that if I wasn't shooting, I felt like I had to come in here and sit down at the computer and spend the whole day at the computer. And like, looking back on that, why? What's the point of that? Aren't you doing something you like so that you could go do the thing you like? And then when you're not doing that, when you're not doing work, you can actually be a person. So I missed out on a bit of that, which I think we all do. It's natural. It's your business. You're afraid. You're trying to advance it. So what I'm trying to say is that it's important to understand the things that you can be doing, that you should be doing. And when you don't have anything to do, use that time to plan something next week or next month, or to kind of get some ideas written down. Don't try to fill your time with busy work just so you don't feel guilty. Zoom out and think about the things that would help you in 6 months or a year. You know, the connections you could be making with people, the trips you could be planning, or not even trips, the shoots, activities. What could you do now to start and plant that seed to have something that comes to fruition later? It sounds like some sort of sermon. Anyway, in my mind, that is way more valuable than just kind of feeling a low-grade stress and doing busy work on the computer. You may as well just be working at a job you don't really like. So that's a big thing. Okay, the second word I have, I know what that means. Resist the urge at all costs. Resist the urge to fall into the trap of following the trends. If you're following the trends, you are wasting time. You are erasing the one thing that would give you any sort of advantage or leverage in the industry anyway, which is yourself. And you're devaluing your work and your brand, your image, whatever. There are a billion people doing everything, right? Why would anyone ever pick you or pick me to shoot anything? There's probably someone that lives closer, has done it more, is cheaper, faster, whatever. So if you're lining up to just stand in the crowd and hope and pray that something's going to happen for you, you're going to have a bad time. Yes, that's a South Park reference. I've said this before to a lot of people, and again, one person, my opinion, all that. But the thing you can do to separate yourself is to be yourself. Look up, once again, the Helsinki bus route theory. It's fantastic. Stay on the bus. Spend time creating the things that you feel like you need to create. And that brings us to action. No brand is going to come to you and ask you to shoot your dream shoot if you've not already created those things in the past. And so what you need to do is get your friends, your family, whoever it is, and spend time and create these things that you want to put out in the world. And that doesn't mean you need to max out your credit card and go do some shitty photo trip in Iceland. Nothing against Iceland. I love it. You know what I'm saying. You don't need to spend a lot of money and follow some trend. No, you can operate close to home for little amounts of money. But the thing that is going to help you greatly is those connections with people. And I've got a couple of personal shoots actually that I've done that I kind of want to do an analysis of in future videos where, you know, it's a totally personal shoot. There's no money being changed hands. But it could not have happened without the help of friends. And so I'd like to illustrate in the future how truly powerful that is. But anyway, whatever it is that you want to do, you need to find out a way to make it or to build up to it on your own. Then and only then, and if you ask any art buyer, anyone in companies or agencies that hire people, they're looking for people who have created a body of work. Doesn't have to be extensive. Up-and-coming photographers get hired all the time, but you need a clear, cohesive vision of what it is that you want to do and what you're going to bring to the table that's different than anyone else. And if you know that, great, go do it. And if you don't know that, just keep shooting. Over time, you're going to identify the things that really you're drawn to, the things that you think about creating all the time. And so when you figure that out, go after it, go make it. And again, you can work small and locally and cheaply. You can do all of these things and utilize the connections that you can make. Be good to people. Be so good to people that they can't wait to shoot with you again. Don't use people, anything like that. Once again, your business is basically going to be a reflection of who you are. So how you deal with everyone and everything is a reflection of you. And when you have people on your side who want to shoot with you, who want to help you, that's one of the biggest assets you can have. That's going to carry over in more ways in the future than you can even imagine right now. So yeah, photo career is not going to happen for you. You've got to happen to it. You can do it. Get to work. If you have any questions, send me an email, leave a comment. If you found value in any of this, I would love a comment or a like or a subscribe, whatever. Hopefully this is helpful. Have a good day.